Hey folks, it's Frithgar here, how you doing? Welcome back to Farming Simulator 22 here in the pristine, untouched wilderness of the Calmlands. Quite enjoying this today. Landscape, painting. There. I mean, I quite enjoy doing the landscaping anyway. I like the challenge of the job. That's going to be too big, isn't it? Oh no, I was using that before. That's what I was using here, wasn't it? So that's going to come around there, like that. Now, actually, that would probably wear out a bit more, and there wouldn't be so much grass, because we've only just gotten here. So we can do it like that, and then if we find that the trailers need a bit more space than that, then we can do something about it. So we'll put that in there. And then I'm also going to want a little bit of a track that's going to come off of here. Now, admittedly, we do have a new area here that has only just been built. So, sort of technically, we wouldn't really be doing this just yet. But I figure I might as well put that in now so that it's all there and ready to go. I think that's about it, really. There is one more little bit that we've got to do. And that is, I got to sculpt this. This is too much of an angle here. So I'm going to have to sculpt this in and get this to blend downwards properly. Otherwise, it's just going to look weird. So come back over there. And I got to raise that like that. And then we go here, as you've seen me do several times by now, and then we lower it back down again, and that gets us the correct angle on it, because, as we all know, it doesn't do it right. So if I bring that up like that, that's going to level down the track a little bit as well, and smooth everything up through there to a more agreeable level. Right, I think that's going to be okay there. We'll try it out now. We'll just go and get something to drive around it. I'm not going to use the loud tractor. Quite a lot of you have said that you don't really want me to keep that loud tractor. You would like me to do something about it. Where have I put the other tractor? Oh, we're back here. Right, yes. Right, I've got the granary. Yeah, I genuinely don't remember what I was doing up here. Genuinely forgotten now what I was doing. I've got the chickens. Hang on a minute. I need to... Yeah. I took a break from recording, and it's ended up being like 2 weeks of breaks. So, I don't fully remember what I was doing. We do want to get rid of this torpedo tractor, and we want to get rid of the other one. We want some slightly more modern tractors. The torpedo one can stay for a while, at least. A lot of you have said that you really, really don't like the other one. I'm assuming it's because of the horrible noise that it makes, and I don't blame you. I'm not a great fan of that tractor either. So that one will be the first one to go. Then we will see about getting rid of this one as well. Changing this one up. Why is it going so slowly here today? This doesn't make a lot of sense. Like that. It doesn't. Not quite sure why it's dragging its heels on this. It's not like I'm. It's set at 15k for some reason. It's like it's working. I wonder if that's got anything to do with the auto-load trailer. Huh. This is a genuinely confusing and confuddling moment for me. I'm really... absolutely... Yeah, I'm just really confused. Why is it doing this? Right, what we are going to do, though, is we're going to go in here, and we've got Euro pallet right there, and liquid tank, big bag pallet. Load that one onto there. Stop loading. Let's turn that off. And take this big bag pallet back home. Right. Now it's going faster. Now we're running down the hill. Alright, that was really weird. I don't know why that one decided that it could only do 15k for the duration of that little trip there, but it seems alright now. And then we'll come in here. We have 14,000 euros left from the stuff that we were doing. We've got a little bit of seed in this one. We don't have enough food of any kind to feed chickens or anything yet, so it's going to be... We're not going to buy chickens just yet. Come on up here. Now, I'm going to need to put some of these things away. So, first up, we're going to unhitch that one. The seed over here, I'm going to see if I can carefully put it back in under this way. I got lime there. I don't know if I can make this pop in beside the lime. So you can take straps off, and then if you just press U like that, and then it's the right-hand control button, and then the WASD keys to move these around. So if I drop that over to there, and then I press I... Perfect. Look at that. Okay. Absolute perfection, even if I do say so myself. Now, I'm going to just reverse that one around here like this. There. Now, although we do have the ability to go and get some more logs later, I'm kind of the opinion at the moment that I don't want to get too many logs if I can help it. I don't want to spend lots of time doing logging. So, if I'm able to... He's done it again. Going to 15k. Something about this vehicle right here. It's either that or it's the tractor itself. It's got something that's putting a speed limit on it. Now he goes. He just started to speed up there a little bit. I don't know. I don't really know what's going on with that. Let's drop that there, and then we can reverse up here and get this one on. There we go. Alrighty then. Now, let's have a look and see if we can get round our different areas. So, we've got the new chicken area. It's a little bit rough here. I'd actually like to spend longer smoothing that out. This is really sharp. I actually need that bit of track there to be different than that. That's not okay as it is. This one here, it's a little bit rough, but actually it's fine. I love the look of the old track coming through here. It's not exactly perfect as we go through, but there's no jarring transitions as we go over like the brow of the hill or anything. It's not set at like an angle or anything. It just sort of, it's not not the smoothest, but that's absolutely fine. That's not going to be a problem for us at all. So the only thing that we want to do is just make a slight alteration to this one, where it needs to actually come out and then up round that way a bit more. So let's just enlarge that one. That one can come up round there, and you can come up like that. That will go here. So that will come back down, and then that will go that way, like that. Hopefully let's bring it down this way, shall we? Go like that. There. And then, if I shrink that down a little bit, and go to this one for a minute, I'll put that one going through there, and I'll put it that way, like that. Make that a bit bigger. Actually, we'll just put that onto grass, like that, for now. Put that through here. Go back to this one. Pull that down there. Go to plants. And here. Well, if you try to do this in a square, it makes a terrible mess of it. You want to just do little bits like this. There we go. So all you need to do is fill it in, just add a little bit in like that, and then we'll also do a bit in here as well, a few bits. Doesn't actually look out of place doing it like that. And I'll do a few little bits of grass here, just sort of growing up in clumps through the dirt there, like that. I think that'll be all right. Okay, let's try this again. So we come up through here, we tip out into the feed trough right there, and then we come on round this way. That's a little better. It's not ideal, but that's absolutely fine. I'm quite okay with that. And then we'll bring this one up this way, and we can park up, and job done. Right, that's us for the night. I've got a couple little squares up there that I need to do something with. They shouldn't be like that. This one is not parked very well. So let me stop there. These... I was going to get rid of these, wasn't I? I didn't want them. And then we were going to... ploughing! That's what we were going to do. We were going to start ploughing this bit up here. Right, so we want to just go into the painting a minute, and I'll go to grass here. Let's make that a little bit bigger, and then go like that, and I'm just gonna paint these over, these little bits that have come up like that. I'll go and put a bit of grass on them in a second. I'm gonna paint over all of them because I'm not quite sure where we're gonna put the edge of the field. So I figure it would be better if I just paint over them all at the moment. Like this. There we go. Oh, another bit over there. It may, it doesn't actually look that out of place once we've just done this. I suppose I can always go back later on so that I avoid a little bit of landscaping at the moment. Just go back to it much later and paint it back in again if the little patches without the grass are too jarring. But I think that's actually everything. That's looking all right. That's looking neat and tidy. Gotten rid of all the stumps. We've got everything done that we wanted to do. Okay, so ploughing will be next. That's what we're going to want on there. And wait a minute, what was I... Oh, I was wanting a GPS, wasn't I? I want GPS to do the ploughing with. I don't want to do the ploughing with that one. And then I could do spring planting if I had a GPS, but I don't currently have the money to pay for it. So, I mean, I guess I could sell the logging trailer. Was that what I was going to do? No, I wasn't going to sell the logging trailer. It would be a bit daft to sell the logging trailer at the moment, considering how much time and effort we put into getting the thing. Although, I don't actually have all that many things here I can do anything with for selling. There's like a few more trees up there, and there's a couple up here that we can reach, but that's pretty much all the trees, so I could go and sell the logging trailer. That'd make us a bit of money. That might be the answer. That'll allow me to get the GPS, which I can then start doing some ploughing with. Anyway, you know what? We're going to sleep the night. It is a fine January morning. We have just under 14,000 euros. A GPS system is going to cost us 15,000 euros. That logging trailer that we've got with the bit that we've got with it as well, with the dolly itself will get us 3,000, and then this one's another 30 grand. So there is a chunk of money to be earned if we were to sell it, and I do wonder if that's the right thing to do. Not going to do it yet though. What I'm going to do first is I'm going to get that plow on, and I'm going to start ploughing the field. Because if we do get some of the field ploughed up, like if we like mark out the outside edge of where the field is going to be, we can at least do some things. Right, let's carefully wiggle our way out of there like that. And then we'll bring this one back round over here, and I'm just going to put the time scale on 5x speed at the moment. Oh, the other thing was, a lot of you said that you really like the idea of me bringing back random events. Random events that we start on each season. And I have been giving this some thought as to what the random events could be and how we could work this out. I'm not going to start it just yet because I want to make sure that I get these random events correct. I really don't want to mess this up. And I kind of like, I've got some ideas of what I think could be really good random events, but I also, I kind of don't want to have them as bad random events. I'm taking this one quite seriously. So I'm going to do some random events. I'm going to come up with a list, and, some of them are going to be quite savage. Like, if we get some particular, you know, particular bad luck with some of these random events, it is going to hurt us quite a bit. Others are going to be beneficial. There is going to be some beneficial ones, not hugely beneficial. But yeah, so I've got these plans. Right, I think I want a GPS. I want a GPS for this, so I'm going to go and sell the logging trailer. I know it seems utter madness to go and sell that one after all the work that we put into getting the thing in the first place, but I do think that that is the right answer. So we'll just drop that one down there for a minute, and I've got everything else that I want. The only thing that we really... Yeah, it's like, we're set up for arable here. And which means that we're set up for the chickens. So we can get going with the chickens. We can make some money with the chickens. The only thing really that we haven't got is any way to get started on the pigs just yet. We will be getting started on the pigs, and we'll be going with them. But we've at least got that mill up there so that we can take grain up to the mill and we can process it. We can make oil at that mill as well, so we can process all of our spare grain. We can keep back the wheat for the chickens, and that'll do great for year one. And then we can sort of move on after that. But the logging trailer, unless we buy more land with logs and we carry on doing that, this one is kind of money sitting here that we're not going to be using for a while. And I've also been doing an awful lot of logging, so I figure that if we free up this money, we can use it for some other things. And I think that doing this plowing job is a good thing to be doing, so this is what we'll do. We can always go and buy it back later. I can always curse myself for being a fool later for getting rid of this one, but I do feel right now that this is kind of money sitting here that's not being used. And the immediate future, we don't really have much use for it. I can maybe get another load or two from the trees around the high points on our land, but that's it. We've run out then. There's nothing else that we can do with it until we buy more land, and then we specifically have to buy the land with lots of trees on. And I kind of want to avoid doing that. I've been thinking about this quite a bit. And also, fitting in with the random events, not a lot of random events I can do when it comes to logging. So this is why I want to focus more on really going with the farming. We will do a bit more logging. I know there's some of you that would like me to keep going with doing plenty of logging. So I can repair this one, get 2,900 for that one. So repaint and repair, there we go, 3,074. So sell that one. Like that. And then I've got this one right here. We'll do the same, repair it and repaint. It's a little tiny bit extra, so we can sell that one for 34,781. That leaves us with 50,000 euros, which, to be quite frank with you, is not too shabby. So let's jump back this way. That's enough to buy chickens, that is. It's also enough to do this. To get our modification on this tractor. I'll repair it while I'm here. And then customize and add a GPS. 15,000. So I got weight, I got standard. That's the only two options I got for that. Well, I guess we'll go with that one then. So we customize that. 15k for that. Not cheap by any stretch, but it is something that I want. I feel it's going to be quite useful. We'll run back home a minute, and then I'll start doing the plowing. Now, I want the GPS so that I can get a nice straight line up the side of the land that we own on section 6 there. And yes, I know I talked up a big game about getting the next bit of forestry and so on, but I've kind of realized that we are going to be exclusively forestry for like 50 episodes if I do that. And I don't think that's what a lot of you want to see. I know that there are one or two of you that wouldn't mind seeing that. But most of you, I think, would like a bit more variety. And I have been told that several of you would like me to do a little bit of time-lapsing on here, like time-lapsing some of the bigger jobs and stuff like that. And I've thought about this. I'm not going to do it. The reason that I'm not going to do it is because I do 2 time-lapses a week, the actual time-lapse episodes. And I kind of... Some people don't watch those and only watch this content because they don't like time-lapse. And so I'm going to keep the two separate. I'm not going to be time-lapsing stuff in here. Time-lapse is in the full time-lapse episodes, so I won't be doing it on these. So I will just sort of play normally on these ones. So I won't be doing the time-lapse stuff. I will try with the bigger jobs and that to like break it up a bit more. I'm aware that like doing that plowing over there was like just that exclusively for several episodes, and I kind of want to try and figure a way that we can break it up more. One of those ways that I'd like to do that is by having more hired help, so having extra helpers and things like that. There's something that I am going to try and work towards, is getting more helpers to do things for us. I think that would be an excellent idea. So what I'm going to do here, I'll bring this one over here. So I'm sort of near the edge of our field boundary right here. And then I'm going to, so you go Alt-C like that to turn it on in the first place. And then Control-S brings this one up. We go into, actually, let's just go here. So I want snap terrain on, offset reversal, automatically invert the offset on a turn. I don't want to do that because we've got a reversible plow, so it does it itself. Don't need to worry about any of the rest of it. So we've got A and B line method. So you just click set A like that, press escape to come out of here, and all I need to do is just drive forward a little bit. There, that's just going to give me a straight line for reference. I don't actually need to do very much. It's sort of about like that. And then set B, and it's done. That's all I needed to do. Okay? So I can save track to farm. We give the track a name. This is just going to be plough. You don't need to give it anything more than that. The location doesn't matter. This is just called a plough. And I'm going to save it there. So save the track, scope to the farm of the vehicle. By default, it's accessible for everybody. So there, I've done that. I don't need to do anything. If I do that, it saves it over there. So now I've got that one saved. So then if I come over to here, this is a bit where we start to set it up now. Actually, oops, Control-S. There's one bit that I always like to have, and if we've got headland management, lines, show lines. I actually like to have those. Line offset, set the line for more ground clearance. Basically what that does, it just lifts it up off the ground a bit so that you can see it through the crops. So sometimes you want it a bit higher than that. This is the default with lines right here. Now obviously this isn't quite right, is it? So if I go with Alt X and I line that one up a minute, like that, and then I go forward here. So that's nowhere near what our machine is. That's because we need to now set the width. So you just click auto width on there and it will automatically adjust. And it's also got this bit down here. So we've got offset there at minus 1.15 and total width is 3.33. Don't alter any of that. Don't touch any of it. You don't need to. Just leave it as it is. And then go to here. The only thing that I'll be using is the rotate 90 degrees. Now, what this is going to do is the tractor, because it's got the offset reversal. I know a lot of you already know how to use this. This is just a quick rundown for those that don't. if you haven't got a plough, if you've just got a normal implement, it doesn't do anything with this. This is on zero. It just goes on that, and it runs up the green line. But this bit is the offset. Because the plough works on one side, it offsets. So the tractor actually will run along there, and then the plough, the middle of it, is on the green line. So if we look here, that tractor is now going to run onto this red line here on the side. And then the plough is going in between the blue lines. That's how it will work. So if I reverse up here, tractor is now following those lines. I'm not steering at all. The GPS is now doing that steering for me, which is absolutely fantastic. Now bring that to there. Now, if you want to move it, you press the left alt button and then page up and page down. And that just slides it sideways a little bit, if that's what you want to do. So I'm going to slide it sideways over there. And my arrow on that little map there is pretty close to the edge of our field now. This is the land that we own right here. I'd say that's probably close enough to the edge of our land. So we'll do that. So I'm going to bring that back to... That's where we're going to start. I will allow create fields. I think it's just press Y. Yes, I don't need to shift Y or anything like that. Drop you in there. I'm not touching the steering at all. The GPS is doing all of that for me. And we can just run up through here. Huge number of you saying over and over and over, turn off the stones. The stones in this game are absolutely nothing like they would be in real life. Huge, like, most of you have said that. Some of you have said turning off the stones is sort of making it less hardcore. And it's a game mechanic that just makes it a bit more hardcore. But almost all of, like, overwhelming majority of you have said turn off the stones, because the stones, in actual fact, don't represent real life in any way, shape, or form. They're not even close to real life. And they don't really do anything. They're just an irritation. So I'm going to do that. Field stone, I'm going to turn that off. Everything else is staying as it is. Also, the crop destruction is off. And I know that some of you really don't like the fact that I've turned off the crop destruction. Unfortunately, you cannot please all of the people all of the time. Now, what else I also cannot do is... I'm not going to leave it there. I don't like that. So I'm going to come over here by two widths. Over to here. And I'll do Alt-X and line that one up. Because I think, actually, the edge of our field is more over here. So I'll bring you out that way. Like that. Unfortunately, folks, that is all we have got time for today. A massive thank you to everybody who has earned their way into the Great Book of Names. To find out some more details about all the names coming past, please head into the description and click on the link to the Discord. It's a link to another video. The link is on the other video. Please also consider checking out the links there for Nitrado, who provide gaming servers for games like Farming Simulator, Minecraft, Ark, and several others. And there's also Fanatical, who will help support your gaming habit by providing you with cheap games and also giving me a small commission on anything that you buy using my link. If you've enjoyed this particular video, then please head down below and give us a like. And if you really enjoyed it, then please tell your friends all about me. Get them to come and watch as well. That would be awesome. And until next time, thank you very much for watching. This is Frithgar. Goodbye, and see you later.